pen. Look good. I'm going to upset the mic on you.
Smells good for you? Please silence your phones.
Thank you. the skies above blue.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Taylor, if you'll take her hand.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks, Josh. Thank you. Love you guys.
Please remain standing as we pray. Father God, thank you for this day. Thank you for this couple who are coming together to join their hearts in holy marriage. I thank you for this day. I thank you for your son that came and died on our cross, that we could have a day like this and come before you and you be glorified and honored through this couple. Thank you for everything you've given us. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. You two can just hold hands.
Okay.
Come on, get it together. Go talk. Dearly beloved and honored guest, we are here today because of these two people standing before you, Lexi and Taylor. This is a very important moment in their lives, and they wanted you all here to witness it and celebrate in a sacred event. Lexi and Taylor are here to invoke the universal and eternal tradition, the tradition of marriage. Two souls to create one, one union that is more than the sum of its parts. And today is when we will witness the genesis of this marriage. Reading from Corinthians 1:13. Everybody is familiar with this, but I want to talk to you two about this as well. Corinthians 1:13 says this: Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful and conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in the other's faults, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, and to hope. It is always ready to endure whatever comes. True love does not come to an end. So you've heard that many times at weddings before, and you've heard that biblical verse in other places. But I want you two to know that, yes, love is patient and love is kind, but sometimes we're not. Sometimes we have bad days. It doesn't mean we don't love. We just may not be showing love that day. And so when one is down, one may be having a bad day, one may not be being kind. It doesn't give the other the right to not be kind. Love is never boastful or conceited, but sometimes we are. It's never rude or selfish. Love isn't. Sometimes we are. It does not take offense, and it's not resentful. Those days that we're rude, most times we don't mean what we say. Love takes no pleasure in others' faults, but delights in the truth. You two have to come together and delight in each other's truth and accept each other's faults. True love does not come to an end. Like I said, we're not always patient. We're not always kind. We're not always loving. But we should show grace to each other. Because if you're expecting this marriage to be something that's perfect, it's only perfect because of Christ. It's only perfect because of God. And it will be a battle. The world is full of so many things that will flip your life upside down. I know through actions that I've seen through both of you that you're prepared for those times of negative. Taylor, as I used to go to their house, and I would see you brushing Lexi's hair. I would take shots at you for that. And I would say, "What are you doing?" And she'd say, "He always brushes my hair." But what I think that really is it's practice for the times when life is tough. God forbid, I pray it never happens to you. But there may be a day that she needs you to brush her hair. And you're prepared. You're prepared to keep her looking beautiful. And that's what you were saying all those times that you've done that. Even though a guy like me is sitting there messing with you, I think you did the right thing. I know your heart. And I know the things that you're willing to do for people, including my people, and the things that you were willing to do. And your intent to make other people stay beautiful with the career field that you've chosen. I want you to take this marriage and make him feel like the most special guy that's ever walked the earth. No matter when he's this nice young age or feeling like a train wreck body at my age, make him feel special. At this moment, I would like you each to declare your intent. And Taylor, I'll start with you. Taylor, do you take Lexi for your lawful wedded wife to live in holy matrimony? Will you love, honor, and comfort and cherish her from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her for as long as you both shall live? If so, say I do.
I do.
Now, Lexi. You got to do better than that.
Okay.
Do you take Taylor for your lawful wedded husband to live in holy matrimony? Will you love, honor, comfort, cherish him from this day forward, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him for as long as you both shall live. If so, say I do.
I do.
That was better.
Thank you.
At this time, Taylor and Lexi would like to exchange vows, and they've written their own vows. So I'm just guessing if you have tissue, you may need those. We're going to start with Taylor. Taylor, when you're ready.
Okay. Whew. Alexis, as we stand here today in front of God, our family, friends, and each other at this beautiful venue in this beautiful city, I want to make a promise to you that I plan to keep until my final breath on earth. Our story is not one many people can lay claim to. Actually, less than 2% of high school sweethearts end up getting married to each other. In the United States, you're actually just as likely to be bitten by a dog. So, needless to say, I certainly did not expect that I would be answering a call from my future wife to get to the homecoming dance at WHS in the fall of 2017. Despite the odds, answering that call would be the best thing that that young, ignorant 16-year-old boy, I can't see, would ever do. What came from that phone call would change my life in the most amazing yet unimaginable way. Falling in love at such a young age would allow us to grow up together. You taught me how to love, how to communicate and embrace my emotions, and how to navigate the hardest moments of life. You have been there for me every step of the way with unwavering love and support, whether it meant us navigating, being at different schools, different careers, or even packing up and moving to a different state 7 hours away from home. Alexis, you are the most caring and selfless person I have ever met. You truly are my rock, my backbone, and my home base. Whether I have had a stressful day at work, am stressing about the future, or simply just had a tough workout, I know I can count on you to comfort me by any means necessary. You put your dreams and aspirations on pause so that I could pursue mine. And that is the most admirable thing a partner can do, and I can never thank you enough for that. You are my best friend, and I never want that to change for as long as I live. With all that being said, I want to promise you a few things. First, I promise to always communicate with you through the highs and the lows, no matter how hard it may be. I promise to make light of every bad situation and to not take for granted the good. I promise to always trust your judgment because your wife is always right. I promise to strive to be the absolute best version of myself because you deserve nothing but the best. And I promise to always put our family at the top of my priorities. Lastly, I promise to forever love you above anyone and everything on this earth. Love, Tay.
Okay. I practiced a lot.
It's okay. It's okay. Don't be nervous. Don't be nervous. It's okay.
To my dear love, to be present with you in this moment is the greatest gift I could ever ask. I can't even begin to put into words how excited I am to become your wife today. I've dreamed about this day for what seems to be forever, and I've thought for a long time of what I would say to you. When you told me you wanted to write our own vows, I was nervous. Not about what to say, but finding the words to express my love for you. From the moment I met you, I knew you were a prized possession. I have loved you from the moment I met you. And I know that seems like such a crazy thing to say from such a young age, but I have fallen madly and hopelessly in love with you. not only as my significant other, but as my best friend. Over the last 6 years, you've taught me so much. You've taught me patience, kindness, confidence, and how to love someone hard and unconditionally. You've granted me grace when I had my doubts, shined a light on all of my darkness, been my rock when I needed stability.
That's okay.
And have been my home when I was no longer there. I took a lot of time to think about all the promises to grant to you. I know there's cheesy ones like, I promise to wake you up with a warm cup of coffee, but my love for you is deeper than just acts of service, and we all know I'm not waking up that early. However, my cheesy vow is that I vow to always let you watch college football and play fantasy whenever you want.
Yeah. Round of applause for that one.
But on a serious note, I vow to be your safe place to run to when you need protection and your place of comfort when you need a quiet reflection. I vow to lift you on the days you find yourself dragging through. I vow to always remind you of your potential because you have shown me more than you will ever see. I vow to always listen to you. I vow to never judge you and to always allow you to express yourself in the best way that you choose. I vow to be your calm after every storm because our love will always stand the rain. I vow to always choose you and put us first. I vow to always be present and live today like it's our last. I vow to never run away from you and the obstacles we may face, but instead hit them head on. I vow to show our future children what love is and how to love their spouse. I vow to never deceive you, but instead love you to my core shamelessly. And lastly, I vow that when death does take my hand, I promise to find you in every lifetime. I can't wait to see what God has planned out for our life. However, I know that I will always love you loudly, proudly, and happily. I hope that every day of the rest of our lives are spent loving each other because not a single thing in this world could convince me to love anyone else. And from the wise words of Edward Cullen, no measure of time with you will be long enough, but let's start with forever. And I'm ready to start our forever.
Join hands. Taylor, if you'll repeat after me. I, Taylor.
I, Taylor.
Take Lexi.
Take Lexi.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
Honor and cherish.
Honor and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Now, Lexi, if you'll repeat after me. I, Lexi.
I, Lexi.
Take Taylor.
Take Taylor.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love.
To love.
Honor and cherish.
Honor and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
At this time, Lexi and Taylor will exchange their wedding rings.
Thanks, baby.
The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. And now, as a token of your love and of your deep desire to forever be united in heart and soul, Taylor, if you'll place the ring. Repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
Now, Lexi, if you'll please. Lexi, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
The true art of a married life is in this inner spiritual journey. It is an enrichment between you two. A give and take between two personalities, a mingling of two endowments, which diminishes neither, but enhances both of you. Inasmuch as you, Taylor, you and Lexi have consented together in this union of matrimony, and you have pledged your faith to each other in the presence of God and everybody here, your family and your friends. And now, by the authority vested in me, in the greatest state in this country, go Tigers, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Taylor Deck.
Forget me, hey, that's the way it seems. Last appointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a shame.
Whoa!
Down in my mind. I'm a believer. I'm a believer. That's right.
I don't know what we're doing.
Congratulations. Thank you. Turn you right back around, change the music, and go down.
Awesome. We need to.
Okay, I'll come around.
Okay.
All right, camera.
Oh, yeah. What a life. What a time to be alive. Couldn't be happier.
Well, Mary.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wait, how are we doing this?
I don't know. It's supposed to pick us up.
Oh!
You're welcome back.
I don't know. I think the carriage is going to pick us up.
Is it actually?
I think. Okay. Walk it right back.
We're walking. We're.
Okay.
Walking inside, I guess.
Oh, wait.
Give me your best dance move.
Hey. Hey. Ooh. Do you want me to hold this?
Of course.
Let me hold this. Get my arm.
I still have pajamas on under this.
I don't know what's going on.
I don't either. I know.
This will be an everlasting love.
You want to do a spin? Or is it too much of the dress? Too much of the dress.
This will be the first time anyone ever loved me.
Sorry.
Oh. Oh. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Guys.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Of course, marriage
life is winning NOLA. How's the sitting arrangements?
Oh boy, dude,
you did great reading.
Thanks, I tried. I kept looking over at Marcus.
It's over here, girl.
There's my bow.
Hey, Taylor. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to sit.